Viking missile.
One thing Tyson have is that he's been knocked out before by a lesser opponent, and he's going to sleep again.
March 18th, Mike Tyson, Razor Ruddock. Razor Ruddock died. If he doesn't die, it doesn't count. If he's not dead, it doesn't count.
Come Saturday, I'm going to fuck Gennady up. Have a good day.
I would never let a white boy beat me. I would never let a white boy beat me. And you can call it any statement you want. Anybody can print that. I would never lose to a white person.
I can't wait, man. It's gonna be
taking advantage of what you saw.
You know what I'm gonna do? Cause you don't ever give me a fair shake. You know that? So I'm gonna go and let you talk to Victor Ortiz. All right? I'm through. They put somebody else up and give me an interview.
What are you talking about?
You heard him. You never give me a fair shake. HBO need to fire you. You don't know shit about boxing. You ain't shit. You not shit.
I wish I was 50 years younger and I'd kick your ass.
You won't do shit.
Well, Henry Cooper's nothing but a tramp. He's a bum. I'm the world's greatest. He must fall in 5 rounds, but if you talk about me, I'll cut it 3. I'll never fight another fella as tough as Doug Jones, not even that big ugly bear Sonny Liston.
Is he your next fight?
Well, after I annihilate this Henry Cooper, I want that bear.
And what's going to happen to him?
I want him bad.
What's going to happen to him?
He might be great, but he'll fall in 8.
I had a little chat with him, but I think I upset him when I said that he's stylistically, he's not the most exciting fighter, and nobody's really getting excited about Andre Ward when he fights. And I think that sort of got his back up. I had a little chat with him and I said, you know, I don't mean any disrespect. I'm just being honest. I'm not talking personalities. I'm talking boxing. And your style will put a grass eye to sleep.
I don't like fighters who talk too much.
Vladimir Klitschko. He's not tough enough. He's not ready for me yet. You know what I mean? I would be a waste of my time to go fight him. I would knock him out.
Heavyweight champion Adonis Stevenson doesn't seem as though he wants to fight you right now. For the money at this time. What do you think about that situation?
I don't want to speak about Adonis Stevenson. Adonis Stevenson, piece of shit. For me. Oh, sorry for my English.
If Madonna want to fight me, I'll fuck him up. They talk a pay-per-view, let's make it happen.
Madonna's name has been bandied about quite a bit. Is that the one fight you'd like the best? That would presumably be a welterweight.
Well, my first pick is Matisse. But he got a fight already with Danny Garcia, and I'm pulling for Danny Garcia. Pause. No homo. You know what I'm saying? Like, I wanted to fight Matisse since he's the one that everybody's scared of. But if I got to go get a Madonna, I'll go get a Madonna. They're nothing scared of me. They both got losses.
Chris Eubank Jr., he sucks cock. He's so shit as a joke. Honestly, he's just terrible. Chris Eubank Jr., he's just... do you know what? I would love to say what I want to say about him. The man's a fanny. Yeah, honestly, he is. His dad is... I would do to Chris Eubank Jr. what Kawasaki done to his dad. Play with him. Absolute play with him. He's shit. I mean, if I couldn't beat Chris Eubank Jr. in 5 rounds, I swear my son's life, I'd give up boxing. I would be disgusted. My dad would probably beat me with a chain.
The man to beat me haven't been born yet.
And in the build-up to this fight, you verbally trashed him, all but calling him a bum. Why?
Well, it really don't matter to me. He can bring the pressure. He can box. I'm a true champion. I'm willing to go to his turf in Atlantic City. I'm going to step on him. I'm going to crush him. Y'all can mark my words to this. I'm going to crush him. He's a C-plus fighter. I'm an A-plus fighter. Come Saturday night next week, all the fans tune in because I'm going to dominate. This guy is flat-footed, swing wild. I'm not worried about who his trainer is because his trainer can't get in there and fight for him. The fans in Atlantic City can't get in there and fight for him. I'm ready mentally, physically. I want all the fans to tune in because I'm going to treat him like he's a C-plus fighter. I'm going to dominate. I'm going to dog this fighter.
Seriously, shit.
What were your thoughts on this previous Klitschko Hay bout?
I mean, Bisco gay fight. I mean, I fell asleep after 4 rounds, so it is what it is. Even though he's a clown.
Seriously, shit.
I predict that this will be Buster's last stand. I will do to Buster what the Indians did to Custer. I'm gonna wipe him out.
Queen Khan's getting it. You know, he's been putting things on Twitter, you know, bless him. Someone must have been telling him, best of luck. I know you don't like me. The fact is he's getting it. I know that Stewardo's watching. Hey, listen, you're getting it next, boy. I'm the champ of the world, me. I'm the boy.
40 pounds, he's the guy you want?
If Matisse win, tell him to line up, because I'm going to fuck Madonna up first, and then I'm going to go get Matisse.
Seriously, he's shit.
All people watching this interview, I'm seriously trying to get Joe Frazier and George Foreman in one night and to go down as the greatest fight of all time. Some of them still have doubt. They're making excuses. I want to whoop both of these men in one night, and I'll have a record that nobody can touch.
Mike, you're jumping around. You seem to be a little anxious.
I'm just ready to get it on and crush this guy's skull and show who the real world champion is.
Beginning, I was real upset that my earlier opponent, David Haye, could not perform because this night I will punish him badly. Postponed for 2 weeks, and probably I'm gonna follow him, but then he postponed for 4 weeks, for 6 weeks. I can't take this guy serious. And I told him in the beginning, get in the freaking line and deserve chance to fight for the championship. Not with your mouth, with a dirty mouth, but with a fist. Deserve a chance to become number one in the mandatory and get the fight. Like a lot of heavyweights in this division.
What will happen when it happens?
I will knock him out in the 12th, as I promised before.
Seriously, shit.
Not interested in Christian, am I? Let him be what he beats. Confidence as he is. If I can't beat him, going nowhere, am I? If I can't hit him one time and knock him clean out, what use am I? He's a bum from Romania who can't speak English. Useless he looks to me. He's got two cross eyes. He looks like he should be in a disabled place. Never mind in a boxing ring with Tyson Fury. So it's hard to get motivated with an idiot like that. And the press conference was, like, terrible, you know. It was crap, really boring, no motivation, nothing, because it's hard to take a guy to pieces with words when he can't understand you. I could probably look at him and say, you are an idiot, loser. Oh, thank you. Hi, man. Good man. It's just crazy.
And for Roy Jones said that he would do Miles Thomas turn, no cut, bring it on, Roy. Bring it on, Roy. I'm here. I'm putting out the challenge to you. All you have to do is accept.
But I tell you, the biggest fight that I've been waiting for, and that's with Sugar Ray Leonard. Now that he's gone out of the game, now I only have one other thing to do, and that's to fight Thomas Hearns. And I'm planning on breaking every bone in his body.
I'm sure you're aware of this fight between Nigel Benn and Chris Eubank. Are you watching it with interest? Who do you think will win, and are you looking forward to taking one of them on?
I don't care who wins, and I'll fight either one of them. I mean, I'll fight both of them on the same night if he wants to.
You punk ass white boy, come here and tell me that if I fuck you in your ass, you punk white boy, you faggot, you can't touch me, you're not man enough. I eat your asshole alive, you bitch. Fuck you, you hoe. Come and say in my face, fuck you, ass for everybody. You bitch, come on, you bitch. You scared coward. You're not man enough to fuck with me. You can't last 2 minutes in my world, bitch. Look at you, scared now, you hoe. Scared like a little white pussy. Scared of the real man. I'll fuck you till you love me, faggot.
Yeah! Yeah! Vladimir Klitschko, boxing champion, David Haye, we'll mix it up. But one person, both of them, really don't want to.
David Gay and Vitaly Klitschko. You guys, man, it's hoe versus hoe, man. The best hoe win.
It's due to happen, because we're getting closer every day.
Thomas, it sounds like he's ready.
Yeah, well, it sounds like
I'm still shaking,
ready.
Tommy. I'm still shaking.
After watching this fight, watching the replay of this fight, this Duran Hearns fight, Marv, I know you're definitely scared. I can see you shaking. You're shaking like a leaf on a tree right now. And just a matter of time before you fall.
Oh, yeah. Let me tell you, you're never going to make it to the light heavyweight because first you have to get through me.
That'll be an easy test.
Oh, okay. Action. Put the name on the contract.
I'd like to promote
this. I
think
contracts don't mean anything anymore.
Listen, man, they call me the problem, but you could call me the can man, because anybody can get it. Africans, Americans, Dominicans, Mexicans, anybody can get it.
If you really, really want to get technical about the whole thing, Rocky couldn't carry my jock strap. If I hurt your feelings back there, so fucking what?
I'm gonna win this title. I'm not gonna, you know what? I don't even. If it wasn't for you for the title, I'm gonna fuck this guy up. Right. Fuck this guy.
Let's go,
this
guy.
Now he's yapping. So before, I had respect for him. Because you know what? He was a quiet dude. You know what? I was like, alright, that's cool. But now, I'm gonna fuck you up.
One question, Heimer.
I'm not motivated for a guy like Christian Hammer. I paid no interest to him in the build up to the fight. I tried to watch his fight, I thought I'll examine him a bit. So I watched him on YouTube for about 30 seconds, and I turned it off because it was shit.
How dare you talk to me like that? You should get up and kneel to me now, and I'll spare you the night of the 28th.
I'd also say, you come in and you come ready. You understand? Because I'm going to come ready. You understand?
Okay.
Okay, you know that.
I don't know why you talk to me like that when you know I'll kill you for it.
That's what I like about you, Mike. You talk tough. Mike Tyson is Mike Tyson. He's a ignorant little kid, you know what I mean? And he's going to be like that. I don't want to bring myself down to his level, so I don't really even want to cherish that thought. I'm going to go in there and we're going to fight, and that's the bottom line.
Oh, man, I can't wait till the 28th. I'm going to make you my girlfriend.
Let me tell you something, you. Hey.
You hear that?
You know something? I'm not even going to dignify that with a hand. So you know why I'm not dignify that with a hand? So because I'm going to bring myself down to your level. There's something you can't buy in that class, and you don't got none of that.
You're sweet. I'm going to make sure you kiss me good with those big lips.
So his resume don't stand for nothing, and he don't stand for nothing because he's chinless. And when I land on him, he's dead. Well, he probably won't die, but he hit the floor very sharp.
Very tiring tour, but it's nice to come back, see my friends, see my family. Floyd, will you stop touching me dick, you puff?
We know Vladimir Klitschko is a massive fan of the Cassidy and Helder show. Have you got a message for Klitschko?
Yes, I have. Vladimir Klitschko, suck my balls. How about that?
I've missed my son, my six-year-old son. I've missed for a week, but I probably haven't missed him quite as much as you would probably think because I've had the fortune to spend the full week with another fucking six-year-old.
Roy.
Well, like I said, he stepped up to challenge me. Anybody challenge me, guys get dogged out. That's my job. You know, I'm not going to say that somebody challenged me, going to say, oh, he's a nice guy and all that. I'm not going to do that. A man challenging me, he's going to get dogged out.
What about you, Roy? Anybody who come into the ring against you got to get dogged out too?
Nah, you don't got to get dogged out. You just got to get taught a lesson.
How are you going to teach him a lesson? Tell us what's going to happen in the fight.
That's all I can do. I got to go out there and do what I got to do to teach that lesson.
You can't. Can nobody teach me a lesson? I'm the teacher, baby. I'm the
teacher.
I'm breaking you up. That's all I gotta say. Breaking you,
we'll
baby.
See coming
to 18. Fight.
I'm your Huckleberry. That's just what I'm looking for.
Get your track shoes on.
My game.
Get your track shoes on, boy.
That's just my game.
I'm knocking your punk ass out.
All right,
said,
gentlemen.
I'm your Huckleberry.
We understand.
Bring it on. I'm about to shoot you down.
Bring it on. Bring
all right. We hear you. Thanks very much, Roy Jones Jr. and James Toney. We appreciate your time.
You said that I think you're a great fighter, and I want to be just like you when I get up in the ranks.
Shane, I barely know who the fuck you are. The fuck you mean I want to be like you? How I want to be like you? Come on, man. I'm the face of boxing. I'm the cash cow. I hold the record for pay-per-view. Me. For the highest gate, me.
Last time Mike Tyson said it doesn't count unless he's dead.
Well, he's still alive, so we gotta do it again.
All right, now, Ferdy.